Hi friend! May is already coming to a close, and the sky is starting to show signs of a summer sun. So today I invite you to get out your bullet journal and plan for the month of June with me. For this month's theme, I'm focusing on the outdoors. After 2 full months of staying in, I have realized just how much I took nature for granted. And this is coming from someone who's a natural homebody. But now I have a newfound appreciation for the outside. And after analyzing the film My Neighbor Totoro for a video essay project I had for one of my finals, I want to escape to a beautiful outdoor paradise. Of course, my longing for leaving my house has romanticized my view of the outdoors, but I am attempting to recreate this sort of utopic perception of it through my spreads this month. My video essay was actually about how the film is a vehicle for nostalgic escapism, and I think that really describes the feeling I'm going for with this theme. Much like how that film is an escape to the past before Japan had modernized much of their countryside, my June spreads are an escape to the outdoors now that the pandemic has kept me in. And for the color palette, I'm going with warm golden yellows, a sky blue, and this almost olive green tone. On a separate sheet of paper, I'm lettering out my June title in calligraphy. Then I cut it out, and I left a small white border around the word, so it kind of looks like a sticker. I love mixing fonts together and layering different colors and patterns on top of each other. It gives my spreads the appearance of complexity without being too over the top and cluttered. I like to add cutouts and washi tape in last to fill in any of the empty space and balance out the overall shape and color of my collage. For the monthly overview, I'm starting by pasting down this image, which is actually a screenshot from My Neighbor Totoro. For that video essay project, I probably watched this film over 3 times in succession, and during one of my many rewatches of it, I started taking some screenshots of the scenes just because they were so pretty. Miyazaki and Ghibli are just great at what they do. So it was only fitting that one of those screenshots made it onto the page of my journal this month. Just like in my May setup, I'm keeping my calendar small. The only thing I have on my schedule is an online summer course. So aside from that, I don't think I'll have much to write down here anyway, so I can just save the space and use it for decorating. And for the calendar itself, I'm keeping the design very simple. I wanted to have open ends on all sides of it to give this sort of freeing effect. Last month, I used a lot of closed box shapes in my spreads, so for June, I wanted to open it all up. On the adjacent page, I am trimming down this piece of lined paper, where I plan on writing my goals for this month. I plan on layering it over this green gingham pattern paper. This design just reminds me of a picnic blanket, which definitely ties in with my whole theme of going outside. A few days ago, I actually started planning out a picnic day for when the whole shelter-in-place restrictions are lifted and it's actually deemed safe to go outside again, because I've been watching a lot of YouTube videos of people cooking and making simple sandwiches and snack ideas, and I really want to try some of these recipes out. I'm using this bubble letter font, as I did on my previous page, for the goal title. These bubble letters are just so easy and fun to make, and they go with the whole playful, whimsical aesthetic thing I've got going on here. One of my goals this month is actually to improve on my drawing skills. Growing up, I've always had an artistic inclination. I would doodle and draw occasionally, but I never really took any of that seriously. And I think that if I really worked on it every day, I could definitely see significant improvement. So my overarching goal is to like eventually develop my own sort of art style. And that is something that can only happen if I begin drawing more. At least for the month of June, I have set the goal to draw something every day. It doesn't have to be anything big or complicated. Just a doodle or a sketch a day will suffice. I want to get into that feeling of drawing more frequently and becoming more comfortable with drawing. And I guess that will build confidence and maybe some type of style will manifest itself. That's the hope. On the right side of my goals section, I am turning this little sliver of space into a vertical tracker for my sleep and mood. I plan on filling in my hours of sleep with a horizontal bar graph, so I'll just color in how many hours of sleep I've gotten each night. And then I'll plot my mood on a line graph. And my mood isn't quantified, as I said before, so I'll just make a line to indicate if my mood has been better or worse than the previous day. Taking a light blue memo pad, I'm filling in this last space of the page with my exercise log. I'm creating this mini calendar with blue paper so it stands out against the busy gingham pattern. I measured out the square for each day so that it's approximately the same size as the journal's grid spacing, so everything is more cohesive. And I also made a key on the same blue paper for the different colors that I will use to fill in my tracker. This style of tracker worked really well for me last month, and it added a lot more color to my page. So this may become a staple in my bullet journal for the months to come. I am finishing off this spread with some small pieces of washi tape to block off the unused spaces on my calendar. On the next page, I am bringing back the gratitude log. I found it to be something that I greatly enjoyed filling in over the month of May, as it made me focus more on the positive parts of my everyday. I would write down one thing that had made me smile during that day each night before bed, and it would force me to recall any good memories that I had. If I found myself struggling to think of something to write down, I would look back at the most simple parts of my day. Maybe I had a really good meal, or maybe my brother shared a joke or two with me. Even those very little things that are easy to forget about are something that brought me a brief happiness or joy in the moment. And it's these little moments that I really do appreciate and want to write down, because it's so easy to overlook something that small and seemingly insignificant, but if you start focusing on that more, it may bring you more happiness in general. So after I had filled in my gratitude log for the day, I would go to my daily trackers for my sleep and mood, and I found that after reflecting upon my happy moments throughout the day, I would think of my mood as being pretty good usually. So I was able to end most of my days in May on a happy note. Here I am making a page for some of my weekly journal prompts. In one of my most recent videos, I started a new diary journal. While I don't have a hard time coming up with things to write about in it, I thought it may be fun to change up my typical diary entries. Usually I would write about things that had happened to me during the day and reflect upon my feelings towards them. But I thought it could be insightful if I chose a prompt at the beginning of each week to answer. I was planning on centering my prompts around the theme of growing up and asking questions like, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Or what is your dream career? What I hope to do is to come back to these prompts in maybe like a year or something and write a response to my entries. I think it would be cool to see how my answers may change as I grow older, and ultimately, it would document the process of me building my own identity. I haven't decided upon the prompts I will actually use yet, but when I do, I will write them down here to reference for when I fill in my diary. Now, on to my weekly spreads. These spreads were just a free-for-all in terms of page layouts and designs. For the first week, I am using more pictures from My Neighbor Totoro. The world in this film is just so beautiful and summery, it was impossible to resist putting more of this movie into my journal. I think it would actually have to be my favorite Ghibli film that I have seen so far. Totoro and Howl's Moving Castle are my favorites. Yes, definitely my favorites, but I think Totoro ekes out Howl for the top spot just due to how freaking adorable it is. I have never smiled so much while watching a movie than I have while watching Totoro. All the characters are just so cute and they have the purest of intentions, and it just makes me all warm and happy inside. And the scenery and soundtrack are just so gorgeous and peaceful. They're out of this world. I could talk about this film for hours. It's no wonder that I chose to do my video project on this. I really did actually research the film and the historical context for many hours over the span of many weeks. So I just have like an information database in my mind about My Neighbor Totoro and this period in Japan. I'll just cut myself off here before I get way too into it and start talking to the point of no return. But that reminds me, I'm gonna try watching all of the Studio Ghibli films by the end of summer. I've already seen a bunch, but there are still many on my to-watch list. I've mostly seen the Miyazaki films, and I've yet to see the other ones that are directed by like Takahata and the other directors under Ghibli. Actually, I think this weekend I'm going to watch Grave of the Fireflies. Finally. I have been procrastinating on watching that one for many years at this point because I know I'm just going to cry throughout it all. But I'm not going out anytime soon, so you know, no one has to see my puffy eyes the day after I watch it. I think I'm just going to go chronologically and watch the movies in order of release. Perhaps I will make a journal spread later to track all the movies I have to watch. I'm sorry if you're not familiar with Studio Ghibli and have no idea what I've just been talking about for the past few minutes, but first of all, how dare you? And second of all, I would highly recommend you check one out this summer. They're just a grand old time, and I think they put me in a summer mood, and it would be a nice way to pass all of this free time we've got. I have also been playing a lot of video games this past month. I have yet to get my hands on a Switch still, so I have been playing Wii games and DS games. Switches are still hard to come by here in the US, but I actually have my sights set on a Switch Lite. I've seen the Lites actually available on GameStop's website, on Target and Best Buy and all of these electronic stores, but I refuse to buy any other color aside from the coral. The coral Switch Lite is just so cute, and it's pink, and I'm in love with it. I know the turquoise and yellow and gray versions are all available online, but if I'm going to be dropping money on a game console, I'm not going to settle for anything less than my desired color. I've been refreshing the GameStop page every day, ready for the minute the coral switches get restocked because I refuse to pay like triple the price on a sketchy eBay one. But at this rate, I feel like by the time they do get restocked, I will have moved on to other things. Like, I desperately want to play Animal Crossing and Breath of the Wild right now, but I'm going to be starting my summer courses soon and I may just get busy with other things. I guess if that happens to be the case and I no longer want it when it's available, I mean, hey, at least I saved the money. And I've been having a great time just replaying Poke Park and Pokemon Soul Silver over these past few weeks, so it's not like I don't have any games to play. I should probably take my own advice and appreciate what I already have. I think I'm going to try to get through Super Paper Mario for the Wii in this last week of May. We'll see how far I can get before my summer classes start. So that is what I've been up to for these past few weeks now that I am no longer in the spring semester of college. Although I've only been really gaming and journaling and doing fun, relaxing stuff, I have been feeling quite tired lately. It's weird because I've been getting a lot more sleep over these past few weeks, but maybe I'm just oversleeping at this point. So I find myself getting really tired at like only 9 or 10 p.m. But it's also been getting a lot warmer here. These past few days have reached 80 degrees, which is like my ideal temperature because I can wear cute skirts and dresses and stuff, but I have no motivation to dress cutely now, so aside from that. But it's just been really pretty outside lately, so I've been fortunate enough to be able to go on walks around my neighborhood very briefly and enjoy the warmth. So maybe it's the sun that's been making me tired. My neighborhood is only so big though, and my walks don't last that long. I find myself getting a little bored of walking the same path each day. I enjoy walking around and being outside, but I really want to explore new areas. And that's why my theme is all about escaping into another outdoor world, I guess. It's all coming full circle. It's like the few glimpses I have had of the outside on my walks makes me want to go out and explore even more. My last page is a simple review for the month. I'm keeping the decorations minimal here, so I can fill most of the space with writing. I have done a monthly review for a few months so far this year, and it's just a very nice way of reflecting on all that has happened during the month and sort of looking forward to the next one. And with that, I have completed my June bullet journal setup. I'm really happy with how this turned out. I think I achieved the feeling that I was going for with the warm colors and the whimsical, freeing feeling of the outdoors. It is definitely different from my usual pink spreads, and to be honest, I was kind of struggling to think of ideas for the layouts. But it all came together in the end, and I am very satisfied with how it looks. Now my journal has a refreshing pop of blue! Thank you so much for spending your time with me today while I planned for the new month. I hope you are doing well and hanging in there. Take care, friend.